Members, what this bill seeks to do is actually look at the tenure issue. And currently, you know, if a teacher's teaching for 3 years, you get automatic tenure, basically, and it gets renewed every 5 years. And this bill actually talks about looking at performance measures or other measures in order to have somebody and then have the school board actually make a positive affirmation or vote in order to make sure that tenure it moves forward. So we're trying to keep it simple, but really trying to open up that discussion that seems taboo. Tenure's been an issue that people talk about, whether it's pro or con. The other side will say, you know, we're making everybody an at-will employee. And really, we're not trying to do that. What we're really trying to say is, you know, you need to be performing your job well. There's very few teachers, I think, that aren't performing their job well. So I think in the real world, I'm kind of looking at the real world where we get job evaluations. In fact, we get them much more frequently than what this bill does or what, you know, tenure or other performance measures actually today. In fact, tenure, the way it works today, really doesn't look at anything other than your time on the job, and you get a protected contract. And members, I guess I don't feel that that's, I hate to use the word feel, wow, then I seem kind of weird there, but it's, I don't think it's right then, that's probably a better word, that teachers don't have to go through some of the same criteria that we do to keep our jobs. I go through a performance evaluation every year to determine if I'm doing my job properly, if I'm actually learning new things, in my case, in engineering and in biochemistry, so that I'm a benefit to the business. And I believe that teachers today ought to have some evaluation process in the tenure system that works similar to that. So that's really what it is in a nutshell. And